Hey, what is up guys, it's ExcuseMeImJack, and welcome to part 3, or probably part 2, of the Department of Fish and Wildlife Research Facility. So, I randomly decided to make this one in, like, a sandbox, and I thought, you know what, this would actually make for a good video, since it's not a traditional facility. Like a Jurassic World facility or a Jurassic Park facility, and it kind of takes the whole ambience of dinosaurs in the wild. So so this video wasn't that long, and there didn't really have to be a part two since there was not a lot of decorating that needed to be done. The only thing that we could really do was place a few rocks down, do some color grading with the sand and stuff, and that is pretty much it. But anyways, I decided to make this park because I was trying to make the headquarters, and I'm like, it would be nice to make the headquarters here in the map that we start off in the campaign. But I decided that we are going to make the headquarters in a different map because it actually makes more sense, and it will actually be more beautiful. This doesn't really look like the headquarters. It looks... You're like all the way over there. Can you like not make loud noises? But this is more like a camp or of some sort, or like, you know, facility. But the headquarters is going to be so much grander, so, yeah. Anyways, tour time, yay. So, arrival point's right here. I decided to put it, like, in this corner of the map. I was going to put it right here, because my initial, like, build was, it actually went, like, straight along this. Like, along this, like, you know, the fence kept going straight instead of taking a curve. I kind of like this more because this area is so much smaller, and I had to have like condense a lot of stuff here, which actually makes like fits in. This area looks just, you know, nice. It looks like a camp. But other than that, the placement for the buildings is kind of weird. My whole thing for this was pathways. I've been getting into pathways a lot, and having them go between buildings and having buildings on the other side of those buildings. Like, you know, I have my hotel, my restroom, my shelter here. Then behind the shelter, we have a pathway that connects to our staff centers and our small hotels. And I know it's kind of not necessary to have, like, you know, hotels next to each other and, like, not anywhere near dinosaurs. But I decided to put them because, like, it looks, you know, it adds more of that vibe to the facility. Because, like, you have your main center facility over here, right? You have your control center, your science center, your expedition center, all your sensors are right here. And then we have, you know, all the way over here, we have our response facility, and we have our large power station. And on the wall, we have our hatcheries and our research platforms. So, that's cool, right? Oh, we also have our tours. So originally I was gonna only do one tour, but I decided to add another one in here, just to have this one pathway that goes like that, have a reason to like actually go and connect to something. again, pathways are my thing, apparently. But yeah, there's not really much to say about this area anymore. So let's go on to the actual fence. So technically, it kind of gives the vibe that the dinosaurs are not the ones that are enclosed in, you know, enclosures. We are the ones. We are the ones that are, like, you know, behind a fence on all sides. And these guys are roaming free. Although the vegetation kind of doesn't really make sense. It looks more like man-made than it does natural, because you know this is everything else is sparse with like you know vegetation and everything, and then all of a sudden you have just this green plain of grass, trees, and stuff. It kind of looks all right. I like this, you know, if you're view. This was actually my first time messing around with the terrain tools, like the slope and the what is it called? Slope and the raise tools. So that kind of looks cool. I just wanted to add more variety in the terrain because it's not gonna be all flat. That's gonna look weird. So I decided to like, you know, add some, you know, hills and stuff. But the actual fence now. So I always wanted to make this fence like two like wide, like two fences. Because, you know, they're over here, you're over here, kind of divides you evenly. I put ranger posts in the middle of the fences so I can actually set my ranger team to check on them. And when I go into the ranger patrol view, we actually have all of our fence under monitor just in case any dinosaurs are uncomfortable and they decide to try to break the fence. The fence is, I think, a level 4 fence, which gives it some time, so the ranger team or the capture team can go sedate the animal and then move on. So that's cool. And I also have, you know, a patrol, a ranger patrol, going through the little area every once in a while. You can see him. He's scanning. I have him there just so he can do something. Plus, if there are any dinosaurs in the radius, they'll get scanned. That was cool. But other than that, let's actually move on to the enclosure. So, we have a lot of water for a desert map. I decided to do that because I wanted to like have like the whole river vibe, and so there wasn't just random oasis of like water, but the oasis probably would have been okay. But yeah, I wanted to do one big like the scene from Jurassic Park where they go over like the hill and then you see all them moving, something like that. So that's why I have like this big lake. Then I just randomly made streams from the big lake going outward. I think I originally started with, I want to say this one, and I went down here and I just actually looped. I wasn't going to connect this, but I decided to connect this, and then I just connected it back and I made a longer one. So they all go back to right here. This stream right here though, this one, it wasn't going to be here. It was because the Dreadnoticus, their comfort zone, yeah, you can see that it doesn't reach the water itself, like a lot of it, so they're not gonna go down here. So they actually drink from this stream and this stream. Plus their food is all right here anyways, so they kind of isolate themselves. I also have like, you know, rocks everywhere. A few rocks. No, I didn't want to put too many down, but there are rocks around. And then I have these little towers. I like these towers. These towers actually look cool. They're my favorite out of all of them. Like, okay, so this is the Jurassic World one. You know, modern look, right? Modern-esque. And then you have the Jurassic Park one, which is just straight up a cage. But I like the inside of this one because, you know, I think it gives the most visibility, like on the right and the left, you know. I feel like the one from Jurassic World, you're kind of too far to the right. But yeah, I like this. Oh, the moon. I decided to add this little pond just because, you know, I feel like there shouldn't just be water outside, there should be water on the inside. But there are quite a bit of dinosaurs. I actually didn't remember putting this many in there. So I believe I have Allosaurus, Stegosaurus, Coelophysis, Compsognathus, Gallimimus, Pachycephalosaurus, Pachyrhinosaurus, Parasaurolophus, Dreadnoticus, Ankylosaurus, and the Baryonyx. I believe those are all the dinosaurs I have in this park. Trying to see if there's anything else. No, there isn't. I think I pointed this out in my last video. I love the Ankylosaurus. Like, so like, it looks so like thick. So big. They did something about the sizes. And the sizes actually work out well. And I love the little compies. Look at him. Look at him. Just hopping. Just hopping around. Hop, 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 hop. I wonder if these guys can pack hunt. That would be funny if they could pack hunt. For like, you know, only smaller ones. I don't know, something like that. I would love to see some Compsognathus, large pack hunting. That would be funny to see. Obviously, it would need to be balanced, but. That'd be funny. Like, a group of 10 packies taking down a Gallimimus. I feel like the balancing would be a little bit, like, weird for that. Like, trying to figure out the balancing. Because right now, I think two Velociraptors or two Dilos can take down a Brachiosaur, which doesn't really make sense. I had issues with that in one of my challenge roads. And it didn't really make sense. And I'm like, okay, why? You can see that the Stegosaurus broke up. Or the Stegosaurus got, attacked by the Ranger capture team. Something's going on. But yeah, also, my pathing for the tour vehicles, I don't really have anything for that. I just randomly put it on the outside because I didn't want it to really go through rivers and stuff. My practice build for this went through rivers. But I kind of like how it doesn't, and it goes on the outside of the map, because, you know, it kind of leaves you in suspense on what's on the inside of the map, and that's also what the game platforms are for. I also followed like the terrain when it came to the tours, so that's why I didn't like directly go from right here to right here. I went around through the little valley. And then back around through the valley again, along the river. So I feel like that was a better choice than just going straight over. Because obviously going through the mountains, or going over the mountains would be kind of weird. It does get kind of weird right here because it goes up and over. I should probably fix that. Just a little bit, you know. Fixed it a little bit. Oh, right here definitely as well. Yeah, some of these mountains I didn't really take care of, okay, not much. Alright, but yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed the whole three parts in one video. I was kind of seeing that with the lack of interest in some of the other videos that I posted that were like part two and three. I kind of noticed that the first week as well. So I'm like, okay, would you guys like it if it was all in one part? And that actually makes it better for me, because I want to really play this game a lot. And basically, doing one speed build a week kind of didn't eat up a lot of time. It really only took like 4 or 5 hours a week. So it was kind of eh. Plus the speed build was very, very quick. This is probably going to be like the length of a normal video, probably a little bit over an hour. But that's because it's mostly just, the only thing that you really had to plan out was this area. So, but yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe. I have channel memberships and I have a Discord server coming soon. I'm just waiting a little while to set up those two things so I just have quite a base so I could have those things up and, you know, have people actually join them. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Bye guys.